Hey friend, I have been using ChatGPT every single day for the past 2 years. And in this video, I want to share with you my 3 favorite ways of using ChatGPT to be more productive. So for those who don't know me, my name is Pascal and I'm an IT consultant based in the Netherlands. So the first way that I use ChatGPT is summarization. In my job as an IT consultant, it is very important to stay ahead of the game. You really need to dive into new technologies, you need to read articles, and you need to stay up to date with the latest research. It is so difficult to do all that while you're also helping clients. So I found a way to quickly get all the information in a fraction of the time. So let me show you how I do that. So I usually go on these kind of websites to find research articles, but I don't really have the time to read through all of them. So what I do is when I find an article that I think is interesting, and usually I get around 5 articles or so, simply open up the HTML experimental version, so you get the web version, and then copy the URL, and then open up ChatGPT, and then use the following prompt. Read the following research paper, and then you paste in the URL. Tell me the main reason why I should read it, and then proceed to write a summary in 3 simple paragraphs. Provide your answers in English, and if you want to have a different language, then you can specify the language over here. Create a short glossary underneath the article with the most difficult words. When I let ChatGPT include a glossary, it makes it much easier to understand. So let's just hit enter. And as you can see, ChatGPT found the article and then just continue to write 1, 2, 3 short paragraphs. And then it also included a glossary. So it basically says, what are diffusion models? A class of generative models that learn to produce data by reversing diffusion process. Well, yeah. So this works for me as an IT consultant, but this can be applied to many different industries. For example, in healthcare, where a health practitioner needs to do administration, they need to help clients. And it's also expected of them to stay up to date with the latest research. This way, you can actually read multiple articles in the time that it took to read just one. All right, so now it's time for use case number 2, and that is something that I call transformative languages. As you know, ChatGPT is based on a large language model. When we refer to the language part, we don't only mean English, Spanish, French, and whatever language you can come up with. There are also languages, let's say computer languages, that you can use in ChatGPT. And with these transformative languages, you can push ChatGPT's output way past just boring text and images. You can create diagrams, you can create applications, and even web pages. Let me show you. So in this example, I basically asked ChatGPT to create a simple web page in HTML that allows me to play a game of Minesweeper. And within less than a few seconds, it came up with this code. And then I just copied this code, installed and pasted it into a code editor, and then just open up the website. And as you can see, I have a fully functioning game of Minesweeper. I can just click over here. And game over. Yeah, pretty much like how I remembered playing as a kid. And of course, I don't make games on a daily basis, but I use that to create tools, just like the flashcard tool you see in my website. So that's HTML. But one of my favorite transformative languages is called Mermaid. And with Mermaid, you can actually create diagrams. So let's say that I am working on a project plan and I need to include a Gantt chart. Usually, I would just open up Excel and start playing around to create a Gantt chart. But now I just use ChatGPT. Let's open it up and use the following prompt. Create a Gantt chart of a website and branding rollout plan. Create this using the Mermaid syntax. And then we get the Mermaid syntax back. If you will paste this in your project plan, then people will look at you like you're weird. So in order to change that, let's just copy this code and then paste it into an editor that will actually transform this code into a working diagram. Copy the code, then go to draw.io, click on arrange, insert, and then advanced, and then on mermaid, and then remove what is there, and then paste in the code. And now click on insert. Now we have our finished Gantt chart. Here you have the different phases, research and planning, design phase, development phase, and testing and launch. Over here we have a timeline, and here are all the tasks that happen over the course of time. And of course, when this displays not the correct timings, or maybe not the correct phases or tasks that you want to be included, just simply double click and then just change it over here. You can change the duration, you can change the tasks, and you can change the phases as well. So yeah, that saves a lot of time. And with Mermaid, you can actually create all sorts of diagrams. And I already have a video on that, which you can check over here. But please do so after I have told you about my third favorite way of using ChatGPT, and that is personas. And with personas, you can actually ask ChatGPT to pretend to be a specific person or act as a role. And the persona that I'm using a lot is asking ChatGPT to act as a critic. Because I don't like ChatGPT always agreeing with me. I want to know how I can improve. So let me show you just a fun way on how to test that. So in this scenario, Terry, my colleague, stole my sandwich from the company fridge. So I asked ChatGPT, hey ChatGPT, act as a critic, tell me what I can improve and why in the following response to Terry. I give it some context. Terry stole my sandwich from the company fridge and I want to send him an email, but don't come across as aggressive. This is my email so far. Terry, you stole my sandwich again. Why don't you just buy your own? It's mine, okay? I'm going to report you to your boss if you do it again. And what is really cool is that ChatGPT came back with a response. The response from ChatGPT is that my email is direct, but it may come across as overly confrontational. And normally ChatGPT just goes ahead and provides you with a new email, but in this case, I can actually learn how to improve it. It says what I need to improve, so the tone, the clarity, and the outcome focus, and also why these improvements matter, and then creates a revised email. I noticed that my sandwich was missing from the fridge again, and I suspect that there may have been some confusion. It has been happening a few times now, and I'd appreciate it if you could ensure this doesn't happen again. I bring my food with the expectation it will still be there when I need it. This is pretty good. I think ChatGPT had some political training. When someone sends you an angry email, you don't want to escalate the situation. So by using ChatGPT, you can de-escalate and still get what you want. And this, of course, also works when you are writing a project plan and ask ChatGPT to act as a critic. Or in this scenario where I asked ChatGPT to create a 2-day travel itinerary for Paris. So ChatGPT came back with a 2-day travel plan, but I felt that this was very tourist-like. So I asked ChatGPT to act as a critic from Paris and look at this plan and tell me what to improve and why. So I use the following prompt: act as a Parisian critic, look at the plan and tell me what should be improved and why. And it says, ah, mon ami, let me put on my Parisian critic hat. Always funny when ChatGPT is so sassy. And then it proceeds with the travel plan. And then within each of the elements that were generated before, ChatGPT now says that you can do this, but actually there's a lesser known gem. Like for example, Treize au Jardin. And if I Google that one, then you will actually see that it is away from the tourist hubs. So yeah, nice, ChatGPT. And other examples of personas include acting as a business coach to give you tips on your business ideas, or asking ChatGPT to act as a business analyst to really find out the root cause of a problem. And there you have it, my three favorite ways on using ChatGPT. Now, I know that was a lot to take in. And if you don't have the time to try this out right now, don't worry, because I've put together a step-by-step guide with all the prompts that we've discussed. Just simply go to my website, fill in your email, and I'll send it straight to your inbox. And that way, you can easily find it whenever you're ready to get started. And if you want to see more creative ways on how to use ChatGPT, then make sure to watch this video next, and I'll see you in the next one.